Hey gang, how's it going? Ben Semisch here, back with another Adobe Premiere quick tip, tutorial, whatever you want to call it. It's Tuesday, here's a video for you. So sometimes you'll have some videos, maybe it's a YouTube video just like this, or maybe it's an interview where you kind of just want to make your subject pop out a little bit more. And I know what's really popular is to do like a mask and then do some things on that, but there is a better way to do it. And it's through using something called HSL Secondary in the Lumetri panel. So let's just kind of start from the beginning here. We imported our footage. It's SLOG3 footage. And you know, maybe this is what your Premiere looks like. So you want to go Window and Lumetri Color, and that'll pull back up this Lumetri Color thing. And then we'll add a LUT, our preset. This is kind of the preset look right here. And there you go. So you know, it's already way better than it was, obviously. So what's cool about HSL Secondary is you can use these color droppers to pick specific colors and then manipulate those colors only. So for example, if we grab this and we click, you see it's grabbed some colors and we're still just like, what did it grab though? But if you click this color gray, now you can see which colors it's affecting. And now this is really good because I have that blue background, so it's gonna be very obvious what colors I want it to pick. But in most cases, you're gonna have to do a little bit of refining. And so they have this plus minus dropper, and you can go in there and kind of add some more, and you can take some away. So just kind of like that, it's very easy. And then you can go in here. The next thing I would suggest you do is where it says refine, denoise, and blur, you wanna turn those up a little bit, just because otherwise you'll get that kind of halo effect, and you definitely don't want that. It's gonna look real crunchy and not great. So what you can do is from there, turn this off. Now we can brighten our selection right here. We can darken our selection right here. We can adjust kind of the overall tint. You know, you can kind of have fun and be weird and add some ghostly effects if you want to do like a 1970s exorcist look. You know, you could do that right there. And you can also break it out into shadows, midtones, and highlights if, you know, that's more your poison. You want to just adjust a little bit into the highlights or the shadows. And again, you know, you've got your brightness, you've got your darkness. But what's also cool is you can go down here, you've got the temperature, you've got tint, but you've got contrast, which is nice. You can add a little bit more contrast than you may have had. Maybe you had like a really big soft light and you kind of wish it was a little harder, or maybe you had a big hard light and you want it a little softer. This could be especially good if somebody has like a lot of wrinkles or blemishes maybe. I mean, you probably wouldn't want to go negative 100 on the contrast, but you could pull it a little bit and that would give you just a little nicer beauty look, I think. You can also add just a little kiss of sharpening, and that'll really kind of pop them out of the background. Saturation could really go either way. It just kind of depends on the camera you use, the LUT you're using, you know, all those things. So, you know, that's kind of just an easy way you can get your subjects to pop. It's just kind of an easy way that you can dial in some things. Maybe if you missed focus just a little bit, or maybe if they, you know, rocked in and out a lot and, you know, you were on a really depth of fieldy kind of look, and maybe they go out of focus just a little bit on a very key thing, you can kind of bump that sharpening up just for that little second, for, you know, just a little bit, and hopefully you can confuse people. That's assuming, obviously, you can't hide it with B-roll. So anyway, hopefully you learned something from this video. If you did, please drop a comment, because that helps me out with the algorithm. Obviously, smash that like button, all the other YouTube garbage. Please subscribe if this is your first time here. I put out new tutorial videos every Tuesday, and videos kind of the other days whenever I kind of feel like it. So as always, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next Tuesday.